Hello second years, welcome back to maths class. So yesterday we discussed about the intersecting lines. If two intersecting circles are there, how we will find the angle. That means in those intersecting circles we will take two intersecting lines, in between the lines you will get the angle. That's why I'm saying intersecting lines. So we'll take, generally angle will be taken in between two intersecting lines. So here two circles will be intersecting, then how we will find the angle? Means generally angle will be found between the two intersecting lines. So at the point of intersection of the circles we have to take two lines, right? They will intersect at that point of intersection, right? There you have to take the angle. So with that we will get angle between two intersecting circles. Yesterday we discussed about that and we got two formulas. We can use any one formula to get our angle. Cos theta, those formulas are in terms of cos theta, but after getting cos theta question is angle, so send cos to other side, you will get your required angle. Okay, now today we will deal with the orthogonality of the circles. When two circles are said to be orthogonal circles, means if the angle between them is 90 degrees, if the angle between them is 90 degrees, then the circles are said to be orthogonal circles. So same thing, how we will get the angle? Means when two circles are intersecting, at the point of intersection you take one tangent to one circle, same at the point of intersection you take the tangent to other circle. So definitely those two lines will intersect. So between the angle we have to consider the angle between the two intersecting circles. Generally how we will get angle? In between two circles, in between two lines if we intersect we will get the angle. So that's why for circles also you take two intersecting lines. So if the angle between them is 90 degrees, right, then those two circles are said to be orthogonal circles. And what is the condition for orthogonality for two circles? Means 2 into gz dash plus ff dash is equal to c plus c dash. So you can ask this question, where is from this g dash, f dash, c dash? Already we know about g, f, c, but what about this g dash, f dash, c dash? So for this you observe, whenever in system of circles two circles are given, you consider first circle as s and second circle as s dash. So your s dash equation will be in terms of g dash, f dash, c dash. Okay, so in system of circles, whenever we take two circles, intersecting circles, right, so we have to compare first one with this s is equal to 0 and second one with s dash is equal to 0. So where the difference comes, you know it, in circles the coefficient of x square and coefficient of y square is always equals to 1. So here comes the difference, right? So different shapes, different how we will get it? If center is different, radius is different, we will get different shapes of circles, isn't it? So difference comes in terms of GFC. Instead of GFC we will have G dash, F dash, C dash. So what is the condition for two circles to be orthogonal? Means they has to satisfy this condition, 2 into GG dash plus FF dash is equal to C plus C dash. Then we can say that those two circles are orthogonal to each other. So whenever it is given like that, orthogonal, you have to compare and you have to check this condition. Okay, so this is about orthogonality. We are doing system of circles, right? So it is a 6 marks topic. Okay, so 1 4 marks question, 1 4 marks question and 1 2 marks question you are going to get in your final examination. Yesterday we discussed about the angle between the two intersecting circles, nothing but where that point of intersection is there, we have taken two intersecting lines, right? Between two intersecting lines only we are going to get the angle. That's why we have taken like that and we got the angle. And we got two formulas in terms of cos theta, right? You can apply any formula. That is the first topic in this. system of circles. Now come to today's topic, orthogonality. When the angle between two circles is 90 degrees, then it is said to be orthogonal circle. They are said to be orthogonal circles. What is the condition for orthogonality? This is the condition. Now come to the question, right? 4 mass question. Find the equation of the circle which passes through 1, 1 and cuts orthogonally each of the circles. So they are saying we have to find such a circle equation which passes through 1, 1 and that circle cuts orthogonally two circles. Here we got this one and we got this one, two circles. Our circle cuts orthogonally with those two circle equations. So come on, how we will solve? Let us see. So it is 4 mass question, most repeated 4 mass question. Whenever we want to find any circle equation, even in circles also we did same thing. We will consider first general circle equation be our required circle equation. So let you take x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0 be the required circle. You consider this as 1, right? So be the required circle equation. Okay, so here it is first point. What is the given point? Given that this circle 1 passes through which point? 1, 1. So come on, it passes through 1, 1 means this point satisfies this equation. 1 square plus 1 square plus 2g into 1, 2f into 1 plus c is equal to 0. So come on, this is 1 plus 1, 2g plus 2f plus c is equal to 0. So 2g plus 2f plus c is equal to minus 2. You consider this as your second equation. Now next, what is the information given to us? This circle cuts another circle orthogonally. So 1 cuts the circle. Which circle? Come on, take the first circle. You consider that as S dash, and generally you know it. We will take the general circle equation as S is equal to 0. So your S dash, first circle, come on, x square plus y square minus 8x minus 2y plus 16 is equal to 0 orthogonally. So it is given that this circle, right, cuts this circle orthogonally. So S dash I have taken. So compare it. We have to take, right, 2g dash is equal to minus 8. All the values in terms of g dash, f dash, c dash, dashes, okay? So 2g dash is equal to minus 8, 2f dash is equal to minus 2, and c dash is equal to 16. So what is your g dash? G dash is equal to minus 4, f dash is equal to minus 1, c dash is equal to 16. But what is the condition for orthogonality? Condition for orthogonality is, come on, it is 2 into gg dash plus ff dash is equal to c plus c dash. Substitute 2 into gg only. Our first circle is this one. So whose g is? G only. F is f, c is c. But g dash, f dash, c dash are given to us indirectly, isn't it? G into g dash. What is g dash? Minus 4 plus f into f dash, it is minus 1, is equal to c plus c dash is 16. So come on, it is 2 into minus 4g minus 1 into f is minus f, okay? So is equal to c plus 16, okay? So f is 2f. Is it correct? Once you check your, yes, correct only. F is minus 1, So it is minus. So come on. Now you can write, open the brackets, minus 8g minus 2f minus c is equal to 16. You consider this as third equation. Okay, so next, given that, one more information is there. What is that? One cuts the circle, another circle. So whenever it cuts orthogonally, we have to compare it as dash only. So x square plus y square minus 4x minus 4y minus 1 is equal to 0, orthogonally same, right? So whenever it is orthogonal, 2g dash is equal to minus 4, 2f dash is equal to minus 4, and c dash is equal to minus 1. So g dash is equal to minus 2, f dash is equal to minus 2, okay, and c dash is equal to minus 1. Condition for orthogonality. So I think already you got this condition, right? What is it? 2 into g g dash plus f f dash is equal to c plus c dash. Substitute 2 into g g only, first circle, so it is g of c minus 2 plus f f dash minus 2, right, is equal to c plus c dash. C dash is plus of minus minus. So 2 into minus 2z minus 2f is equal to c minus 1. Minus 4z minus 4f minus c is equal to minus 1. You consider this as fourth equation. Actually, what is our aim? Find the equation of the circle which passes through 1, 1 and cuts orthogonally these two circle equations. So at the end, we have to substitute GFC in this equation. That will be our final circle equation. That means we have to get GFC. How we have to get GFC? By using the given conditions. So by using the given conditions, we got three equations, 2, 3, 4. Solve these 2, 3, 4. You will get your GFC. So come on. Now first you take second, right? Observe. Here plus c is there in second equation. In third equation, minus c is there. So now you take 2 plus 3. We are solving the equations, right? Why we are doing? To get our GFC values. Finally, we will substitute in that equation. That will be our required circle equation. So come on, what is it? 2g plus 2f plus c is equal to minus 2, and this one is minus 8g minus 2f minus c is equal to 16. So plus c minus c, plus 2f minus 2f cancels. So 2g minus 8g minus 6g is equal to how much? It is 14. So g is equal to 14 by minus 6 minus 7 by 3 is the answer of your g. So now we got g value. You take next third and fourth. Observe, third equation minus c is there and fourth equation minus c is there. Both are having same sign, means we have to take minus. Actually here second, if you observe, here plus c is there and third equation minus c is there. That's why I have taken 2 plus 3, right? So apply your brain while doing these calculations, right? So 3 plus 4, why we have to take 2 plus 3? If we take 3 plus 4, again both will have same sign. So here we have to take 3 minus 4. Here 2 plus 3, why 2 plus 3? Here plus c is there, here minus c is there. If we take plus, both will get cancelled. But if you see third and fourth equations, minus c is there, minus c is there. Both are having same sign. That's why we have to deduct. That's why we have to take 3 minus 4. While taking these values, these solutions, be careful how we have to take. By observing the equations, you have to decide. So come on. Third, it is -8g -2f -c = 16, right? And fourth equation, -4g -4f -c = -1. So we are doing minus, so minus of minus, plus minus of minus, this one also, this one also. So minus c plus c will get cancels. So here -8g + 4g - 4g, -2f + 4f, that is 2f, is equal to, it is 16 + 1 = 17. Okay, so now you got your g value, substitute and try to get your f value. So come on, -4 × -7/3 + 2f = 17. So how much it is? So I'll rub this definition, we will do here. So observe carefully how we are doing. Be conscious with the signs, and while taking the equations also you should be very careful, full attention you have to give. So come on, -into -+4 7 = 28/3 + 2f = 17. Okay, so 2f = 17 - 28/3. So 2f = 3 is the LCM. 3 7s are 21, 3 1s are 3. 51 - 28. How much? 23/3. So come on, 2f = 23/3. So f = 23/, sending this to this side, it is 3 2s are 6. You got your f value. So substitute g and f in any one equation, second equation, so that we can get to c. Our requirements are g, f, c, right? By using the given conditions, we have to get g, f, c. Finally, we have to substitute in this equation. That will be our required circle equation. So substituting g and f in second equation, what is your second equation? 2g, what is the value we got? -7/3 + 2f, what is the value? F value 23/6. Okay, plus c is equal to -2. So 2 1s are 2 3s. We can take 3 as LCM, right? So this is -14, 2 × -7 + 23 + 3c = -2. So how much it is? Come on, -14 + 23, how much? 9 9 + 3c =, sending 3 that side, it is -6. Okay, so implies it is 3c = -6 - 9 = -15. So with that, c = -15/3 = -5. You got all the values. We got g value here, we got f value here, now we got our c value. Therefore required circle equation is from 1, isn't it? So from 1, required circle equation is, wherever g is there, you substitute the values, right? G value, f value, g is -7/3x + f, what is that? 2 × 23/6y, right? Plus c plus 5 = 0. So 2 1s are 2 3s. If we take the 3 as LCM and sending that side, so it is 3 × x² + y² - 14x plus 23y minus 15 is equal to 0 is the required circle equation. Okay, so very simple. First you take one circle, it passes through 1, 1, you'll get one condition. It cuts orthogonally, you'll get another condition. It cuts orthogonally another circle, we'll get third condition. Totally we are having three equations. Solve them and try to get your GFC values. Once you got GFC, you substitute, you'll get your required circle equation. Now come to the second question. So this is your first question. Now go to your second question. What is the second question? Read it carefully. Find the value of K if the two circles are orthogonal. So given that two circles are orthogonal to each other, so find out G dash F dash, right, and apply the condition, you will get your K value. So come on, second question. Given that, what is the first circle? X square plus y square plus 4x plus 8 is equal to 0, and we consider this as s is equal to 0, and s dash, second circle, x square plus y square minus 16y plus k is equal to 0 are orthogonal. So orthogonal means which condition? 2gg dash plus ff dash is equal to c plus c dash. So come on, from the first one you find out 2g is equal to 4, 2f no term is there, 0, and c is equal to 8. Okay, so g is equal to 2, f is equal to 0, c is equal to 8. From this 2g dash, no term, x term, 0, 2f dash minus 16, c dash is equal to k. So g dash is equal to 0, f dash is equal to minus 8, c dash is equal to k. So condition, what is the condition? Condition is 2 into gg dash plus ff dash is equal to c plus c dash. 2 into g is 2, right, gg dash is 0 plus f is 0, f dash is minus 8 is equal to c, 8 plus c dash is k. So 2 into 0 plus 0 is equal to 8 plus k. 0 plus 0, 0, 0 into 2, 0 is equal to 8 plus k, k is equal to minus 8 is the answer. Simple, this is 2 marks question, that one is 4 marks question. Okay, so practice these problems perfectly. So we are using orthogonality condition, 2 into gg dash plus ff dash is equal to c plus c dash. Okay, so if you apply that condition, you will get your required answer. That's all for today. Have a nice day.